really, isn't it? This is a bit of a tamer version, no tongue or anything, but it's still, it's quite a steamy read. Just wrap your listening gear around this. Hello, he heard a calm, reassuring voice say behind him. Richard only realised a gentle, honeyed voice was talking to him when a soft white hand came to rest on his shoulder. Slowly, he turned around and for a few seconds found himself trapped in the gaze of the most piercing blue eyes he had ever seen. I'm your mummy, said the voice, which, when Richard had recovered from the bolt of electricity that passed through him, he saw belonged to one of the most gorgeous women he had ever met. She wasn't classically beautiful, but she exuded sensuality from every pore. Yes, this woman is totty-tastic. Listen to what they say about her in this bit. This is a gawker. I remember once watching her in the bar, and in the end I had to look away, because that kind of naked sexuality made me feel a bit inferior as a woman. She had an incredible effect on the men. They'd be looking at her with their tongues hanging out. That's not all. They are a horny couple, aren't they? Listen to this, is the best bit. This is really sexy. Judy was sitting with her feet up on a chair. And as Richard played, her skirt slid higher and higher up her bare legs. Hello. And he's a bit of a charmer as well, don't you think? Look at this.
Dress smartly and be prepared for anything.
Good advice, Richard. He's a Boy Scout. Isn't he lovely? He's great with kids. He is a... Shut up. Shut up. I love it. He's great with the ladies. He's a, well, Jane Asher. And he's one of the lads, and he's good with the lads, he's good with the ladies. Oh dear, he's a bit fat. Anyway, he is any woman's ideal man, isn't he? Half babysitter, half gigolo. What a fantastic combination. And what I love most about Richard is that he's skinny, because I'm skinny as well. And he's actually called the man with no bum. I'm not, unfortunately not called that, but everyone, I love the fact that he's skinny. Everyone goes on at Judy about her weight and how big she is, but no one mentioned he's skinny, and he is thin. Judy doesn't kiss him, she flosses with him. That is how thin he is. And I've warmed to Judy as well. She gets a hard time. All the criticism she gets about being overweight and looking her age. Come on, she's 48 years old. She's had four kids. What's my excuse for looking like this? As some old lady is bound to have said at some point, they make a lovely couple. And even better, according to this book, they make £1.5 million a year. No wonder they're smiling. I love them. I love this morning. It's the best thing. It's so lovely to see people in love instead of punching each other. You should see them every morning touching each other, feeling each other up, smiling at each other. Go on, make room for them on your sofa tomorrow.
Love is in the air, in the rising of the sun. Love is in the air, when the day is nearly done.
Oh, well, I mean him have a little flirt. Let's see what's coming up in the rest of the show.
Still to come before one, the Gallaghers meet their lady in bed. Football, Paul Tonkinson, chin-chin and all that. And ugly people in face-sucking filth flick.
And now it's time for the criminal records update. Just a bit of information for you. When you ring, you don't speak to a machine, you speak to a very nice old lady, don't you? She's about this big, she's called Grace, and she's there on the phone all day, thousands of calls go, hello? Stuart Anderson, I'll put you through. Our kid making me cry. So go on, give her a call.
He's on one. Give her a call. These are the two vids to choose from.
Yes. And we have some numbers. If you're stuck on Stuart, why not phone 0891 33888 01?
Why not?
And if you're mad for our kids, then you'll be phoning 0891 33888 02. And that's easy. All right, our kids.
And don't forget, the losing pit will never ever be seen again. Meanwhile, as Zebedee said, it's time for bed with the Gallagher brothers.
Chuffing Joe. George, chuffing Alison. All right? Nobody calls me superfluous without explaining what it means.
What are you doing, Art Kid?
I am erasing George Chuffin Harrison from Chuffin history, all right? I am not mad for him calling me a pranny at all.
How dare you violate the holy book?
You what?
I'm going to need that. I've got a difficult third album to write.
I couldn't give a chuff, man. I couldn't give a chuff.
No Beatles songbook, no third album.
Well, it doesn't matter anyway, man. We never got to be as big as the Spice Girls, and I am not mad for being the second biggest band in the world behind a bunch of chuffing slappers.
So, of course, me being the brains behind the operation, I have formulated a plan.
Oh, bang on.
Are you mad for hearing it?
I am triple mad for hearing it, man.
OK, gather round. Oh, not that far.
All right.
Right, now, our superfluous, mono-browed lead singer... Oh, that's you.
Oh, right, right. Yeah.
We'll borrow one of Patsy's frocks.
Nice.
Infiltrate the Spice Girls and then destroy them from within.
I am more mad for that plan than anything I've ever been totally bang up for in the whole of my chuffing life.
Cool.
Trouble is now, I'm so excited, I've never got to be able to get asleep.
Oh, well, try counting something.
Like what?
Perhaps count the songs I'm going to let you sing on the next album.
Oh, yeah, man for it, man for it. Here we go. One. Patsy! I can't reach you, Patsy!
Goodbye, Liam. I'm off to join the Spice Girls.
No! I am not mad for that idea at all!
And I'm taking your favourite beard with me.
Not you and all, Ben. Who else is there left to betray me now?
Ha 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 ha! See you later, Liam. I am in the Spice Girls now and off. 3, 4. Cuckoo, ka-choo, and a zig-a-zig.
No! Bad dream.
Oh, no.
I've seen me past, but I've learnt the errors of my ways. Oh, man. Look, it don't matter if we're number two, number one. None of that matters. The only thing that matters, man, is that you are my brother. All right? And I hate you so much it hurts.
Oh, Liam, our kid. I hate your chuffing guts and all.
Oh.
I've never hated anyone the way I hate you.
Oh. Cuckoo could cuddle, man.
Cuckoo could chuff in all.
Oh.
Come on.
Oh, we all locked up today. Now then, the good news for Dennis Bennis fans is he's back from New York and he'll be doing a report with us from Starstud in London soon. He is in London at the moment, up in the big smoke, and he is helping us. What is he doing? He's helping us breaking the law!
Breaking the law!
My name's Mark Stevens. It remains illegal to this day to impersonate a Chelsea pensioner.
You've noticed at home that we are doing this show in the style of the lottery, because they messed up last night, and I thought, well, if the lottery can do it, we can do it too, but I'm a lot hornier than Guinevere. Meanwhile, Paul, I don't know about him, he's talking about footy bally. Over to
football. Yeah, football. This week in football, Arsenal are top of the league, Liverpool are favourites to win it, and Manchester United started their surge for the Premiership with a 3-1 victory against the mighty Leicester. Yeah! But the most miserable manager has to be Frank Smiler Clark. Poor Nottingham Forest, the bottom of the league. They lost yesterday to Wimbledon. Not that Frank's making any excuses. No excuses. I mean, he's a manager, isn't he?
I'm totally tired. I could bring a player in on loan. But, you know,
why don't you buy some foreign players? What's about that?
To get good players on loan. The only area is abroad, really. And we've been looking there. We've been all over the place. But it's very, very difficult.
Spend some money.
There's no money. I've been aware of that since the start of the season. And... we're in limbo anyway.
They're in limbo. So we decided to launch a Forest in Need appeal. If you want to play for Nottingham Forest free of charge, write to Limbo, care of Frank Prozac Clark, or free phone Brian Clough. He's available from 11 to 11 at the Hare of the Dog Tavern, Nottingham. First, look out, licence payers, beware Gary Lineker. There's a new football pundit in town. Oh, yes, there is. He's got the attitude, he's got the looks. I'm referring, of course, to Pierre Beardy. Here we see his commentary debut at the Great North Run with some killer questions. Amazing, Beardsley.
Right, yeah. How did you enjoy that?
How did you enjoy that? So simple, so eloquent. But why? Why is he getting into it? Why?
I enjoy getting together with the likes of yourselves, Ray, Trevor Brook and people like that, and talking about that side of the game, you know.
Oh, Peter, stay on the pitch. You're better in the box than on the box. But haven't we all dreamed of punditry deep down? Haven't we? No, you haven't, have you? Millions of viewers hanging on every word. I know I have. Yes.
Bliss.
All right, Trafford, here we are, Saturday night. Match.
It's like the United Nations now in the East End of London.
What's any nuts in it, Trafford? Lights on, no one home. Hello, anyone there?
Lomas is the tank with ginger hair.
Tank with ginger hair? What are you on about?
Rising, the ball must be as slippy as a wet baby.
What? No, that's it. That is it. Slippery, kids. That's sick. All right, I'll pay my taxes. Dear BBC. I'm sorry, Trafford. Get up here. You dictate. I am writing to inform you of the idiocy of your commentary services. I hereby tender my application.
Oh, it's on the BBC, Trafford. Dear Paul, I would like to offer you the chance to become an integral member of the grandstand team.
Yes!
At last, a dream realised. Not only had I received my first letter, but I was to earn a crust chatting about footy. First up, a man who was good in the air, but was now sadly losing his hair. Sky Television's Andy Gadget Gray.
I wonder who...
Andy Gray. Oh. Hello. I've just got a job and I need advice on football punditry. I wondered, could you give me anything?
Well, systems information. Do you know anything about them?
Nothing at all.
Right, that's a great place to start. Okay. Take this, for instance. Pass me those two centre-backs, we'll call them. Let's say that's your defence. Do you know the difference between a back four...
Back four, you got four.
That's four.
Yeah.
Good lad. Or... Let's move those. Three centre-backs.
Big lad in there. Tony Adams, back. Good in the air. He's good. He's a bit slow, but there. Well, OK, fine.
Mug up front.
Stick the mug up front, and then that seems a bit...
Who's in goalkeeper? Goalkeeper. Oh,
there's
not much get past him. What, no. That little nose there, Peterish Michael,
that's maybe? Nobody will chip him, will they? And, well, I think that's fine. Well, thank you very much. Could I take these off with me, and then I'll be able to...
Well, you can definitely take Tony Adams. Take him home and
so nobody wants
on that.
Him, really, either.
And you can have a midfield
team. Oh, thank you very much. See you later.
Good luck.
Cheers. I took a 4-4-2 to White City.
Over the barriers, mate. BBC Sport.
And quickly immersed myself in the hustle and bustle of the British Broadcasting Corporation. Anyone could be on television. I was in it. I was a young gun. And yet I realised that I could still learn from the greats. I wondered how he did that. Ah! The man I would replace, a legend who had abolished football's minimum wage with the maximum chin.
Can't sit there, it's Desi's chair, isn't it? The master. Jimmy Hill, nice to meet you. Hello there. I've been meeting people about football punditry, Andy Gray, and he told me all about formations, and I've got me midfield, I've got me back four there, Tony Adams, and I'm wondering, could you give me some advice on punditry, you know, for the... after the game, you know, for the comments and things, you know?
Be thoughtful. But disagree with everything they say.
I don't agree with that.
That's great.
That
good.
Kind of thing.
I like
right.
that.
Okay.
I'd like to try that again, would you?
I'll say I don't agree with that, Jim.
That's very
I'd like
good.
To take issue upon that.
You would? You're frightening me already.
Can you feel it? That kind of yeah, force. I'm getting there, aren't I? I'm getting... No, I don't agree. I disagree.
Now that was very
good.
Now
we're good. Into something. Right,
that
okay,
was very
fine,
good indeed.
Fine. Okay. Good luck in your retirement. Have a good time playing golf and that.
No, I'm not retiring. No.
You're not?
No. I'm definitely not retiring.
Oh, no. I don't understand. I don't understand all this lot.
If I wasn't taking Jimmy's job, then whose? I had my foot in, but I couldn't find a door. And then I heard the voice of football results for 24 years. Of course.
Nationwide League, Division 1.
James Alexander Gordon.
What do you want?
Paul Tonkinson, BBC Sunday Show.
Hello,
nice
Paul.
To meet
nice
you.
Nice to meet you.
Can you give me some tips on how to do it? Because you know, I'm...
Have a go.
I've got five easy. Let's have a look.
Need a microphone. Go on.
Let's have a look at this now. Chelsea, a load of West London poncies with foreign players, won. Newcastle United, £50 million the last 3 years, still no trophy, won. And our late result for the FA Carling Premiership. Middlesbrough, managed by Captain Marvel himself, too. Manchester United, perhaps the best team in the Premiership. Fergie's babes going all the way in Europe, too. Well, it's easy, isn't it? I'd like to congratulate you on and wish you a happy retirement, James. Good luck to you, son.
Paul,
I think you'll do a good job.
Paul,
you know,
listen,
keep the seat warm.
I've got news for you. I've got news for you. I'm not going anywhere. What, I'm staying here for the next 24 years.
The next 24?
Keep practicing. Thanks for coming,
James. Yeah, cheers. Teasing me like that with the results. Give me a go. Keep your ears.
As my granddad said to me halfway through his paper round, if a job's worth doing, it's worth doing well. After all, I was an integral member of the BBC Sports team.
Paul loses out. And Paul, you haven't done a break in the law yet, have you, Paul?
No, I haven't.
What have you done this week?
This week I haven't been breaking the law. Mm. And kids, if you're watching out there, it's much harder to live within the law, isn't it? This week I've been upholding the law.
I'm going straight, I am straight as an arrow.
According to an old coaching law, you're perfectly within your rights to urinate against the rear offside wheel of a vehicle.
I'm going straight.
Taxi! Taxi! Cheers, coffee, tea, man.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm moving around! Get off! I've splashed myself!
I'm going straight. I am straight as an arrow.
It's lovely. Paul gets to pee in every single video he's ever made in his life. I said it last week, I have not got to pee. Why is that? Apparently, if I had done that, I wanted to do that, and they said that it would be offensive. So I thought it would be really good fun. But next week, I insist I'm going to have a poo in Esther Rance's handbag. Meanwhile, here's some news. Esther Rance, who's she? Anyway, Pamela Anderson again, and again, and again. Apparently, she's back with Tommy. This is never-before-seen footage of Pammy out with a mummy, Carol, and her son Brandon earlier this week. It was reported that she's agreed to take hard-living Tommy back, but only if he checks into rehab first. We at The Sunday Show can exclusively reveal that the real reason she's thinking of taking him back is this, the tattoo on her finger. Despite strenuous effort, she failed to find a replacement Tommy. Rumour has it she was even reduced to asking ageing skiffler Tommy Steele. Or Hollywood hunk Tommy Lee Jones. Worst of all, figment of a vicar's imagination, yes, Tommy the Tank Engine. They've all turned the Silicon Babe down. Then Tommy the Tank Engine can build up a good head of steam.
Basketball big guy Michael Jordan has been mucking about with animals. It's official. The most famous rabbit in the world is back. Bugs Bunny props up in the new American movie Space Jam.
What's up?
But he's not starring with Daffy Duck or Porky Pig. Oh no, he's starring with basketball legend Michael Jordan. But Bugs isn't the only one who's caught basketball fever. It's spread to Ratland. But why? What's the point? Because they're developing a rat super league. It's obvious. This rat one-on-one attracted a massive crowd and the kids love it, don't they?
Those rats are wild.
Slam dunk!
That's all, Bugs.
Well, you back to my one.
Unfortunately, both rats later failed the drugs test.
Hello, news in from China. As the world population levels increase day by day, one couple have discovered the greatest contraception ever invented. The newlywed couple have been trying for a child for a few months without success. Repeated home tests only confirmed the worst, and the couple had to try and try again. Bummer. Though months went by and still no sign of a baby arriving. In their frustration, the family went to a specialist to see if he could cure their problem. However, it turns out that the couple's problem was not infertility, but stupidity. The couple, this is true, thought babies came by merely sleeping together in the same bedroom. That constituted a reproductive act. Even Michael Jackson knows you need a test tube. Okay, we've made it by hook and crook. We've made so many mistakes. I don't care, gremlins. Who won the criminal records? Let's have a look at the results. And of course, boy in a skirt. You can't beat that, can you? Right, we're going to play out with that. Thanks to the audience. Thanks for everyone. Goodbye. On its World AIDS Day, wear your badge with pride. See you next week, 12:15.
Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low. Through the streets I'm a cut I'll go. All the lassies shout hello. Donald, where's your trousers? A lassie took me to a ball. It was slippery in the hall. I was feared that I would fall, cause I hadn't on my trousers. Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low. Through the streets I'm a cut I'll go. All the lassies shout hello. Donald, where's your trousers? I went down to London town, had some fun and on the ground. The ladies turned their heads around, saying, Donald, where's your trousers? Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low. Through the streets I'm a cut I'll go. All the lassies shout hello. Donald, where's your trousers? To wear the kilt is my delight. It isn't wrong, I know it's right.